Welcome to TechTrixInfo, the engineering tutorial hub. Today, let's learn about different type of tools used in rock breakers. So, chisel is one of the tools. It will be looking like this, and it's used for penetrative works. Example for mining, foundations, breaking, trenching, and demolition works. We normally use the chisel type tool. Then second one is the moil point. There are two types. One is of the pyramidal type, and there is another of the conical type also. So it's a universal tool, and it's used for layered rocks and reinforced concretes, for breaking layered rocks and reinforced concretes. Then we have the blunt tool. It's a impact breaking, like breaking oversized rocks for mining applications, and also crystalline rock breaking. The blunt tool is commonly used. So let's see the tool properties of moil point, the conical one. So this is conically designed, and so this is a conical moil point. It has good penetration as energy applied through the point. Penetration force applied evenly in all the directions and no torsional effect. You can see a moil point in a conical way. The load is being applied in a circle evenly. So that's how the load is being applied on a rock or the equipment we are breaking when we use a moil point conical tool. Next, the moil point pyramidal one. It also has good penetration as energy applied through the point. Even application of penetration force in two directions, and minimal torsional vibration is happening. So here you can see it's a pyramidal moil point over here, and the load transfer in a pyramidal moil point is being shown here with this diagram over here. Okay, now let's see the chisel tool, its properties. So here we have a chisel tool. This is how a chisel end of the chisel tool looks like. It have effective material penetration as energy applied through the cutting edge, excellent splitting action with forces applied in two directions, and also can be subjected to torsional forces caused by the material. So this is how the load is being transferred. It's been splitting into two directions when a chisel tool is being used. Okay, next is the blunt tool. Energy applied over a large surface area, optimum breaking effect is been done, and no torsional stress on tool, and retaining pins when we use this tool. Minimum penetration effect, because here the area of contact is high. So this is how the end of the tool look like, and this is the load, how it is being given on to a breaking application. So this is normally used for heavy breaking applications, big rocks, etc. So the maximum contact of surface area can be achieved with the help of a blunt tool. For more engineering tutorial video updates, please click the subscribe button on top of this video. If you have find this tutorial useful, please click the like button or drop a comment to motivate us. We are also available on Facebook. Thanks for watching this video.